Hey everybody, how's it going? It's Inferno Men again. Welcome back to the Platinum Randomizer Nuzlocke. In the last episode, if you missed it, it was probably the only episode we've ever had go up on a Saturday, I'm pretty sure, of this series. Because it was the Hour of Power episode. I did an hour-long episode just to do as much as I could get done, and if you missed that episode, make sure you check it out. Of course, as you can see, something happened on the layout. But in between episodes, I leveled everybody up to level 50, including Frozone, who just got added to our team from level 1. So there was a lot of grinding that I did in between episodes, but it was 100% worth it. So now, we are in Mount Coronet, right? That's what it's called, Mount Coronet? Yeah, we're basically in there. Because we're advancing through the story, so we're back to where we're supposed to be going. I used Rock Climb to get up into this area, and I used Repels into this area so we could get our first encounter. So now let's see what our first encounter for this area... Would it be a first encounter? I don't think so, because it's Route 207 still. So I don't think we get a first encounter. But I did use a Repel up to this point, so I should probably still use those Repels. So no encounter here, but there was some pretty interesting Pokemon on the earlier area of Mount Coronet that I didn't think that we were supposed to get an encounter on. But I basically grinded at Snowpoint City by Snowpoint City on Route 217, so it took a bit, and I think we were supposed to stay up there. I didn't mean to jump down these things. Maybe we are supposed to go this way. I don't think so. Yeah, probably not. PP Max, I don't think we have anybody with a 5 PP move, and if it is, it's probably Ancient Power, which is a move that I'm probably going to get rid of pretty soon. I don't know if it happened during the last episode, but, Petunia learned Rock Slide. Hey, there's Looker. Ha, I caught myself before I made that stupid mistake that I kept on making last episode where I was saying, look, it's Looker. Sounds dumb when you say that. But yeah, this episode should be the regular amount of time, but the reason I did an hour-long episode was so I could get this series done sooner than it would have, so I could start a series that I have wanted to do since before starting this channel for the anniversary of my channel, which is coming up on June 10th. And you guys will be viewing this on, what is today? Today's the 23rd, it's a Saturday, so you'll be viewing this on the 25th, so 16 days from where you guys are, if I'm doing my math right, should be my anniversary, so we got a couple weeks. I really like how in Gen 5 they made it so, you could just choose to use another, repel. Pretty sure the Gen 5 games were the games that were ROM-packed for Pokemon Insurgents, which is why you can use multiple repels in a row in that game, too. Alright, Chata, this should be easy to defeat. You can just use a Thunderbolt, that should knock it out. If it doesn't, I'd be surprised. Yeah, look at that. Speaking of Chata, I got one because in Pokemon Go, because I was supposed to go to the St. Louis Safari Zone, which got canceled, or at least postponed, for COVID-19. But I'm not sure if they're still doing it, because we still got the set of challenges, and the Pokemon that would have showed up in St. Louis showed up here. And, so I got 2 shiny Teddy Ursas that day. That day was crazy for shinies. I think I got 5. I got the Teddy Ursa that you're supposed to get at the end of the challenges. I got a shiny Teddy Ursa in the wild from Incense. And I got a shiny Burmy, a shiny Roselia, and then I got all the a bunch of Chatots. Alright, mistake me if I'm wrong, but it seems like we can get an encounter here. No, it's still Mount Coronet, so we don't get an encounter. All right, well that's fine. I don't know what would really be interesting over here, but we could just rock climb all the way up so we can advance here. I most likely have put out the schedule for this week. If I have it, and then I probably forgot to, but hopefully I didn't. But if you guys want to see the whole schedule for the week, go check it out on Twitter. Every week I decide what I'm gonna do on Saturday, so it's most likely just looks the same as it did last week. But you know, the fighter that we're using for Smash Wednesdays this week is Samus, and the episode numbers are different for the series that I'm doing. But see what items over here. Iron Ball, not too important. Our only steel type doesn't have a steel type move, so that's not really important. Yes. And yes, thankfully Suicune can learn Surf, so it knows Surf. It also knows Ice Fang, I believe, Aurora Beam, Bubble Beam, and yeah, Surf, of course. We don't have Waterfall, so we won't be able to go up this waterfall, right? Unless Looker gave us Waterfall for some reason. Yeah, I didn't think so. So we can't go up the waterfall yet, but that's fine. It's not like I really care. And it looks like we probably have to. Well, let me look it up real quick. Waterfall Platinum. How do you get HM Waterfall? Yeah. It says that we have to have the eighth badge. Okay. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna figure out where we go next. Hey guys, I'm back. So, I went back out into the water to surf again, and it turns out that there's actually another side of the water that actually has rock climb instead of waterfall, so we don't even need waterfall. See, there's like Team Galacticra. I just wasn't thinking. I surfed over there, and I totally didn't see the other entrance, and it was through the grass that we already went through, but for some reason, since there was the snow that kind of blends the screen, I kind of couldn't see it. But yeah, Weavile, that's a fairly easy Pokemon to defeat. Four times weak to fighting. Get out of here. One shot? Of course it is. Pokemon should fairly be easy to defeat, especially since we're all at level 50 now. Neo, of course, at level 51 now. Breloom. Alright, we still have a flying type move on Lugia, so we can go and switch out and use that. So yeah, I didn't even need HM Slaves for this game. The HMs we have on our Pokemon, I'm alright with them having. The Rock Smash on Petunia. I just feel like Petunia's main three moves are really important for her to have, so her having Rock Smash is just an open slot. She hasn't wanted to learn any moves that I'd really be interested in giving her, and we haven't gotten any interesting rock type or fire type HMs and TMs. Alright, that's another Pokemon that's four times weak to fighting, so I'll switch back out to Neo. But yeah, so Petunia's got a good move set for now. Of course, she's the team member we use the least, but you know, throwback to when it was a struggle for us to get a full team, and it took about 15 episodes before we actually got a full team. So, you know, I'm just happy to have a full team. Petunia is still a cherished member of the team. Unfortunately, our favorite member of the team passed away last episode, but, you know, that's the curse of the Nuzlocke. You gotta get used to losing your favorite team members, and thankfully, so far, in the Block 2 type block, we haven't lost a single team member, so I don't have to cry over that, but we have 8 deaths so far in this one, but, you know, we're farther in this game, so, you know, if we didn't have a death at this point, I'd be amazed by myself. So we got a Farfetch'd here, super weak to electric, so this should be easy to kill. Yeah. Especially since it's 9 levels lower. Magikarp. I mean, I don't even have to switch out. I was like, should I give experience to Hindrance? But it's a level 40 Magikarp. If it's a Magikarp, it's probably only going to give us, like, 60 experience points, so it doesn't matter who I switch out to. Like, let's see how much we're going to get for this. 171. That's how much you get for a regular Pokemon that's at, like, level 20. Not even that. Like, level 8. That's about as much experience you get for a Pokemon at that level. A Magikarp's level 40 and gave us that much, so, you know, it didn't matter if we switched out. I'm guessing we're not supposed to go in that cave, because there's Rock Climb available over here, and I know... Okay, we are. We are. Forget what I said. I know that there was grass connected to, but you know, it's never a bad idea to check it out, so... Yeah, we're supposed to be in here. Hello, Team Galactic member. Grunt. We still haven't had an encounter with Team Plasma yet in the type block, and I'm really excited because, I can't tell if I like the regular Team Galactic theme or the remix more, but, you know, they're both super good, so... Frick, I forgot this thing has Volt Absorb. Ah, of course it does. Always forget about that. But, you know, we can use Low Kick. Hopefully, I was about to say hopefully it doesn't have Static, but obviously its ability is Volt Absorb. You know, I just woke up about an hour ago, so... Don't kill me if I am making mistakes here, but, you know... My sleep schedule is kind of off. I go to sleep around 4 every day and wake up at 12:30. Well, around 12:30, because, you know, I have to get up before 12:30 because that's when my videos go up. So I have to promote those videos so you guys know when they go up. Yeah, we'll give a Hyper Potion to Neo. You guys may have noticed if you actually watched the Hour of Power episode, that my potions were gone. And that's because, my game stopped recording, and, for some reason, and I had only done a couple of battles, but I had to, stop the recording, go back, redo everything I did in the previous recording, and then go back to where I was, so, and I forgot to buy those Hyper Potions again, so, we could have dodged this trainer, but, you know, she was spinning around in circles, but, now I rebought them. I did not mean to press that button to speed up, but yeah, just in case you're all wondering, or if you even noticed, it's just an accident that the game stopped recording. I know that it was only a couple of battles, but they were important battles, so I just went back and went back to redo them. So, yeah. But I think the Hour of Power went pretty smoothly. Of course, it just went up for me, so I don't know what the final results of viewership was, but... at least for today, because the first 24 hours is always the most important. But... I'm not promising that anybody's going to watch the full episode, but... I know that some people are going to want to at least watch the beginning of it and see how I obtained the badge, and even so, some people might actually pay attention to everything that's going on and just skip through to the important parts, which, happens to be battling Candace and battling the Team Galactic Grunts. Well, battling the Team Galactic admin and leader, because we battled Cyrus and Saturn. So, and Saturn was crazy. But if you didn't miss if you missed the last episode, I won't spoil it for you. But Saturn had an unbelievable team. And I'm not meaning, like, unbelievable, like, oh my god, I can't believe his team was so powerful. I mean, the way it was randomized, the Pokemon he had was unbelievable. It was just... I don't know why the randomizer hated me for that one specific battle, but... The randomizer decided just to kick me in the nuts and, pull my underwear over my head right there. Alright. Gotta use those repels so we don't encounter other Pokemon. You know what I notice? I think if we were rock smash that rock and just went up, we wouldn't have to battle him. I think that's what the point of the rock smash rocks are. But then again, why would they put them there if you could just walk up and then not do the battle? These are the real questions here. Alright, so we don't really have anything super effective against Skuntank here with Surf, but I just wanted you guys to see Suicune in action for the first time. And for some reason, that wasn't a kill. I don't understand why, but now Frozone's poisoned. That is sad. Can we get an F in the chat for that one? This should kill it, though. Doubt that a grunt would use a potion. Was that his only Pokemon? I hope so. No, of course not, because we got hurt by poison. Abomasnow. Alright, we can switch out for that. To Petunia. I don't want... Hopefully we have some status healing items that we can use on Frozone. Okay, this ground has three Pokemon, so... What is up, Abomasnow? Or Obomasnow? Barack Obomasnow. Alright, he's just planting his roots. It's fine. Heal if you wish. Even though you're gonna get one-shotted by this. Down goes his HP. And down goes Abomasnow. And it was a crit. I doubt we wouldn't have needed that crit, but it was a crit. So thank you, Petunia. Hello, Hale. I didn't even realize you were in the cave. Pinsir. We can stay in. I'm not gonna waste 2 turns to fly just to kill a pincer when we can just use Lava Plume and most likely take it out in one hit. Am I right? Is it gonna one-shot this pincer? Heck yeah, it is. Really still can't believe that that Surf didn't one-shot the Skun Tank when it very clearly looked like it did. It survived on 1 HP. Alright, we have a full restore. What types of berries do we have? I don't think we have any poison cure. Yeah, we have burn confusion. Yeah, we're gonna have to use the full restore we have. Which is very sad. But you know what? We can buy more later. I'm pretty sure we can get them after obtaining the 8th badge because I don't remember seeing them in the store. I remember the max potions, but not full restores. Alright, this grunt looks like the last one we have to defeat before going on to the other admins and finally making it to the distortion world. What is up, my guy? What? You're blocking the entrance, my guy. Okay, maybe we're supposed to rock smash these rocks here. That is very sad. I was hoping that we'd be able to go through that doorway, but apparently it's too good to be true. Okay, I'm obviously supposed to rock climb because there's just literally nothing over there. But this is where we came from, right? Yeah, this is where we came from. Where are we going? Clap, clap, clap. To Grandma's house. That is not an exit. Well, shoot. I'm not just gonna go in a circle. Well, thanks for letting me know. Maybe we aren't supposed to be here. Max Repel. Yeah, I feel like we're going in the wrong area, even though that grunt is standing in front of an important doorway that we'd obviously have to go through at some point. But of course he's not letting us through because he doesn't have any Pokemon. Or so he says. Apparently we're not supposed to be going this way. For now. For now. Maybe I missed something back there. I mean, this grunt is by this rock climb wall, but yeah, there's just a giant rock past him, so. Oh, there's rocks over there. I'm so dumb. I didn't notice these rocks. So we are supposed to go this way. Well, at least we don't have to worry about those grunts when we go back there later. I'm guessing we're supposed to go this way? I mean, it's either we go this way by going through the grass or we go this way by moving a boulder, so it doesn't really matter. So we're definitely going in the right way now. Don't think we could have avoided this grass. Metal coat. Nice, but we're not supposed to be going this way. Well, shoot. We're supposed to be going in here. Cave entrance. I'm gonna turn off the timer. I just want to see how far we can get before there is something important in the game. Staircase? Staircase? There's another battle we can do. Can we avoid it? No, we cannot. Alright. Well, I think that we're going to do this battle and finish off, because I don't want this to go too much past 20 minutes. Hopefully this grunt only has a couple of Pokemon. By a couple, I mean two, so if that works. Starting off with a Mareep. Super effective against Frozone, but I defeated a Manectric while grinding up with Surf, so I wouldn't put it past Frozone to knock this thing out with one hit. Yeah, see, look, nothing to worry about there. We one-shotted the Mareep. Love Disc. Easier than easy. Yeah, it seems like this is the right direction to go. I'd be surprised if we get blocked off again. But that's gonna have to be saved for the next episode. Hopefully we get to the Distortion World soon, because that Hour of Power did have a purpose to get as far as we could. So hopefully it doesn't take that much longer. But yeah. Let me just circle around here. That's going to do it for this episode, guys. If you did enjoy, make sure you leave a like on the video. Answer whatever question of the day I come up with down below. Subscribe if you're new. Ring that notification bell. This is Infernoman Burning Out, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.